Morning, River City. Morning, good morning. Wonderful to see everyone here. We are still in the spirit of the resurrection that we experienced through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and we continue to celebrate. So I'm going to invite you to stand as we open up the service. We're going to read together our call to worship. All right, let's read. We come, O God, to worship you, to stand in your presence, to bask in your goodness, to receive the spiritual food we so desperately need. We gather now to be encountered by you. We gather now to be changed by you. Conform our hearts to yours, O God of all.
Amen. Amen. I'm going to invite you to continue standing as we sing to the Lord.
You make all things new. is gone, new life has begun. You have overcome.
The old life,
the old life is gone, new life has begun. You have overcome.
The old life is gone,
the old life is gone, new life has begun. You have overcome.
Jesus,
you made.
Jesus,
you made.
Jesus,
you make all things new.
Thank you. without power in your hands, you have given me a second chance. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Yeah. Wherever you send me, Lord, I will go.
I will go.
Yes, I will go, Jesus.
I will go.
I will follow.
I will follow.
Wherever you send me, Lord.
Wherever you send me,
I will follow.
I will follow.
I will follow.
I will follow.
Yes,
made new every day. Great is your faithfulness toward us. And Lord, where you do lead us, we want to follow. We honestly want to follow, Lord. The confession is, God, that sometimes we don't clearly see where you're going. We don't clearly see what you're doing. And it gets a little scary at times. The confession, God, is sometimes we have doubts, we have insecurities. And we don't clearly understand. But God, our confession to you again this morning is that we do want to follow you. We want to follow you empowered by your spirit as best as we can. In truth and honesty. In full confession before you. Lord, we believe, but sometimes, God, help our unbelief. Be with us, God. Be with us, Lord. In this season of life, be with us, Lord. Bring comfort to our hearts. Bring comfort and peace to our minds. But God, give us that blessed assurance that you are with us.
Wherever you lead.
Affirm your presence, God. We know it. Sometimes we like to see it.
Lord, I will follow you.
Lord, we give you all the glory. And all of the honor. Because you are our Father. And in you are the words of eternal life. So let us draw closer to you. Let us cling to you in all desperation. So, Father, I think about, because we would slip if you do not uphold us. We will fall and falter, God, if you do not uphold us, God. So, Abba, Father, let us wrap our arms around your neck as a child would of
parent.
Let us hold on to you as you are holding on to us. Let us be secured and anchored to you as you have us secured and anchored in your bosom. Let us receive everything that you are giving in this moment, God. Be with us, Lord. Lord, we thank you. We praise you. We worship you. We acknowledge you. We declare you are God. You are our God, the divine one. In your son Jesus' name I pray. Amen. 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 You may be seated. If you want to, you may be seated. I think we just, go ahead, stay there.
Wherever you lead me.
Oh,
together lovely, all together worthy, all together wonderful to me.
Lord, here I am.
Here I am to worship. Here I am to bow down. Here I am to say, you're my God.
Said, and the people of God said,
amen.
And the people of God said,
amen.
Put your hands together, not in adoration for me or anybody else. Put your hands together in adoration of the one true and holy God, the one true sovereign God. We worship him. We worship him, not man. We worship God, not things. We worship God. We worship you, Lord. Welcome. Hallelujah. I can sit there for a welcome. Let me do it. Welcome this morning to River City Community Church in West Tumble Park, Chicago, Illinois, where we worship the one and true living God. Amen. 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 Let's thank God for our pastor of worship and our worship team this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah for moving us into a space of worship, of adoration, and if you're like me, contemplation. In the season of life that we are in, we have questions, right? I said this before and I'll say it, and there's nothing wrong with those questions. We have competing emotions, and there's nothing wrong with those emotions. We have competing thoughts and ideas and worry for the future. And there is nothing wrong with having those competing thoughts and ideas and worry for the future. Beloved, let me tell you this morning, it's okay. It's okay. It really is. It's okay to sit in the tension of not knowing and what once was. It's okay. But in those tensions, we turn to God. Amen?
Amen?
We turn to God in prayer and faith. And as scripture teaches us, with all things, we bring to him in prayer, supplication, and thanksgiving. Cast our anxieties and our cares upon him. Why? Because he cares for us. It doesn't catch him by surprise. I say that a lot. It doesn't catch God. Nothing surprises God. And the Lord knows, right? But sometimes we sit in the space of not knowing. And he wants us to bring that not knowing to him, to receive of him what is needed. So, beloved, this is our time of prayer. And if you have any prayer requests this morning, feel free to shout them out, and I'll try to capture them. If you don't feel comfortable shouting out your prayer request in the community, there is a prayer text line, as you are aware. If you don't know, you can text your prayer request 24 hours a day. You may not get a response to the following morning, but we're sleeping, but you can text your prayer request. And there. Amen. Father, we pray for Daniel. We pray for our pastor. We pray again, Lord, for the season that we are in. We pray for our elders. We pray for our staff who's been going through this process in a way that honors you, honors our pastor, honors you, honors this community. We pray for them, Lord, that they would be strengthened and encouraged for the heavy weight and the mantle that has been placed upon them for such a time as this. We lift up Daniel, we lift up Liz, we lift up Xander, we lift up Gabby, Lord. We pray for them, God, that you would be with them all as this season of life where we are now seems to be coming to a close. May we bring glory and honor to you. Glory and honor in the church. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. All right. Heavy, but we're going to transition. Any celebrations in the community today? Any birthdays we want to call out? What? Your birthday was last week, and your dad's birthday was 2 weeks ago. So real loud, I want you to scream out your name. Logan, what's your dad's name? Matt, who's your dad? Where is he at right now? There you go, Matt on the drums. Logan's birthday. That's it. I love Logan. Yeah. I love it. All right. Yes, ma'am. Pardon me? It's your husband. Wait, who? And? Who that guy? Who that? Antoine Taylor. One of the original OGs of River City Community Church, one of the pillars. Yes, sir. From the beginning. Amen. Any other birthdays or celebrations we got? Yeah. Any other? You got any celebration, anything we're celebrating? Anything we're celebrating? I don't know if we announced it. I don't know if it was announced. I know it was in the prayer chain. Lucille Pitchford, Zay Pitchford's mom, had surgery this week. She had two back-to-back major surgeries. Hard surgeries. Got news this morning, she's out of ICU. She's in her own room. Yesterday, the breathing tube was taken out, and we see a path to recovery. So we praise God. That's a celebration, right? And I'm sorry for being remiss. We thank God for the healing of Sister Lucille Pitchford, and we pray, I ask that you continue to pray for her ongoing healing. Amen? You're going to the concert with your cousin, your dad, and your uncle. It's in Michigan, so we're praying for safe travel. Whose concert? AJR. Okay, I'm old. Who's AJR? Who's AJR? Don't ask. Okay. Don't ask. Sorry, the kids told me to know Uncle Keith knows his place. All right, have a good time. We pray for travel mercy.
Marla's birthday was last week.
Marla's birthday was last Friday. Marla. Got a funny story for you. Marla's birthday was last week, and my eyes are getting worse, and I thought it was Maria, so I sent Maria this nice, long birthday greeting, and she's like, oh, that's so sweet. I'll give it to Marla. All right. Any other celebration and birthdays? Yeah. Woo! Rugby just started. First game is next Sunday.
Yeah. We celebrate. We got a little half. That's been kind of overturned out there a little bit. We're missing some dirt and asphalt. We don't want it back, though. We don't want it. Mateo. All right. Mateo played his first soccer game with the Chicago Fire. What's that last part? Their program, right. Well, he's with Chicago Fire, right. That's amen. Amen. Let's celebrate our high schoolers. Celebrate our high schoolers. Do you know, if you know, and I say this, I've said this before, if you know our high schoolers, encourage them as you walk past them. Ask them, how's it going? Just say, I love you. And let's tell them anything they need, you'll help them out. That's what we do. Amen? All right. Babies, come on up. Sister Jen, come right here. Come on up, babies.
you for our children. Our children who you have right here, right now for us, Lord. We ask that you just continue to love them, Lord. That you continue to put people in their lives who will show them love, who will share with them your truth, Lord, who will keep them safe, Lord, who will have their best interests at heart, Lord, Father. We just pray that you guard their minds from anything that may be trying to come against them, Lord. Lord, that you guard their hearts, their bodies, Lord. Lord, and we pray for the kids who will be coming into this building tomorrow, Lord, and be here throughout the week, Lord. We ask that you just lift them up. Lift up all our children across the city, Lord, all our youth, Lord, and just show them who you are in the everyday lives that they have, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. We're going to invite our worship team back up to the platform.
Nearer, blessed. Nearer, blessed Lord, to the cross. mountain upon his shoulders. Ashamed, I hear my mocking voice call out among the scoffers. It was my sin that held him there until
that in spite of us and in spite of all of our stuff, as Keith said, that doesn't shock you. That's no obstacle for you. And so you arrive at us. How deep is your love? God, we come before you this morning to come to the table, to come to receive and then to partake in your very life in the world. not just to say we love you, not just to say with our lips, oh, we think you're the best. Oh, Jesus, we are your biggest fan. But no, we come to partake in your life, in your reality, in your mission, in your work, in your activity in the world for healing, for justice, for transformation, that all might have life and life abundant in you. How deep is your love? So God, meet us now as we prepare to come into communion. In the name of the triune God, we ask these things, amen and amen. Thank you. I know everyone's already said good morning. You'll notice that the structure of this morning is really different. You've probably already noticed. You're like, wow, that's counted for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 songs or something. So this is not really going to be a traditional sermon. It is a homily, which is a way of saying a baby sermon, a really small one. And I'm going to promise you that I will be 4, 5, 6 minutes, somewhere around there, 32 minutes max. But I promise. I'll be up here and I'll be down here quick when it takes some communion. And so I really just want to help frame communion for us and just to kind of set up what it is we're actually doing, what it is we're participating in. That's going to be a big word. You all hear me say that word all the time. But to participate in communion is to partake not just in something that we believe in intellectually, but it's something that we actually make our lives into. And so our life becomes a part of God's life when we come to this table. And so I want to tie together just really quickly this word community, which we all throw around and can mean a whole host of things. Community, we say that all the time. I need community. This community is good. And then this other word, communion, which I think has a little bit of gravitas and weight to it. And I think we don't use that word to the extent that we could, communion. So community, communion. I think you'll all notice that everyone needs community, and we will find it in all the right places or in all the wrong places. It doesn't really matter. You can be in prison, and folks need community, so they will find it. If there is not a good way of getting community, we'll go to the street corners or the blocks, and we'll find community there. And sometimes when you go to college, you will find out, Luke, you're going to find out, you're going to need some community. You'll need some guys and some girls who will strengthen you and who will sharpen you and who will be with you along for the ride, who will go through the hard things and the good things with you. Community. In a lot of ways in the world, we congregate and build community around average things, like cool things like pickleball. Pickleball's cool. You probably have a pickleball community. Or your fantasy football community. Or whatever it is, you build community. And if you've ever wondered why that is, and this is maybe one point I would like you to reflect on as we go to communion, is that community is inherently in us, and we're built for community, we're wired for community, precisely because in the life of God, community is modeled and patterned. One way we could say this in a shorthand way is to say that God is community. That in the life of God, there is at the very same time distinction and difference and diversity among the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. And yet, at the very same time, there's unity. And at the very same time, there's oneness. And at the very same time, there's cohesion. And so the life of God literally models for us and is the universal pattern for community. And perhaps that's why we're always seeking it, is because, well, God in God's self is community. That there can be difference and still no distance between us. Does that make sense? So that is kind of the essence of community. But if you ever wonder what makes Christian community unique, and this is the important part, the thing that makes Christian community so unique is that unlike pickleball, or unlike the community you will build if you go to fantasy football league, or the community you make at college, and those things are fine and wonderful, is that community for Christians is not necessarily in an ideal, though it may be a good ideal. And it's not even that we're building community on a set of principles or a really good moral or even a really good mission statement. Right? There's a ton of things that have great mission statements. But Christian community is actually founded on a person. And not just on a person, but in the person of Jesus. And so that is, I would just let this settle in. I know it's going to be quick. But that is the essence of Christian community, is that we're founded not on a place, not in a building, not on a set of principles, not on a moral, but in a person. In a person that is, as Ephesians says, is our peace. Christ himself is our peace. The wall of hostility is gone, that he has brought the far off near. And by the blood of Christ, we are made one. So that is Christian community, modeled by God, three in one. Difference without distance. And what makes Christian community so unique is that we find ourselves planted not in a place, but in a person, a living person. And so what we participate in when we go to this and when we go to this is a way of saying we're also participating in this. And when we participate in this, and then we live with Christ, but before we die with Christ, and then as we celebrated last week, we're raised to new life with Christ. And that is our oneness. Our unity is in that reality, and that reality is a person who's alive. Y'all with me on that? Okay, so that's what we do when we say that word communion. So we throw around community, but what we're saying is, okay, our community is actually in the living, resurrected Christ. And then we get to this word communion. And communion, man, communion, it's in my Instagram bio. Not that that is an example of what makes it important, but the word communion, y'all, is so deep. I wish we could use it a little more. When we say we are a community, and so what we seek is communion in the life of God. But then if you notice, the life of God is always for the life of the world. And if we're participating in it, then we too become in communion for the life of the whole world. So I want you, as you come up today, reflect on that word communion, not just as a symbolic bread and wine, but also as a way of being in the world, how you want to posture yourself. Oneness. It does not matter how different you are than me. It does not matter if I like you or do not like you. You notice God never, oh, this would be a sermon for another day. You notice God never changes things by distancing himself from things. You know, but it is communion, that God is bringing all things into God's self, and that's how all things are transformed. So that is what we partake in. Communion, communion with the world, communion with the neighborhood, communion with the situation going on over there. Communion with her reality over here. Communion with the one with whom you are estranged. Oneness all the way down. Oneness, oneness, oneness. Okay? So as you come up, think about that. We are the community of God. Community in a person, alive and at work in you and in us. So that's who we are. And then what we do is communion. Communing. So reflect on that as you come up. Mesley is going to come up, I believe, and lead us in the great sacrament. And this is just an aside. Oh, I'm going over my time. Just as an aside, though, this is what it means to live a sacramental life. If this is a sacrament. To live sacramentally is to act as though we are in communion with all things, that the invisible realities become an embodied reality for us as we live it out in the world. Live a sacramental life. That's why we do this. Okay, I'm talking too long. I got to go. Rest in that. I love you all. Let us come to the table.
Good morning, church. Good morning. Nope.
It's on.
Good morning, church. How deep the Father's love for us. Amen. Benjamin just talked about community and the importance of coming to the table, right, as a community that maybe is hurting, as a community with a lot of hope, a community together, right? We're building something together. We just gave thanks earlier for the asphalt that's missing in the back. Our Building Together campaign, not just us as a church community, but what we are doing for the actual community outside these four church walls. Because when we pray for our kids, we don't just pray for the kids that we see that come up. We pray for those that are in the community that use this space day in and day out. Now that the parking lot is closed, we have to go to Cameron to park the car, right? We pray for those kids that are day in and day out that we may not see. And so we are going to go into our time of confession, and you will see that pop up on the screens. And if we want to stand up as a church. And go into it. God, our great giver, we confess that we have sinned against you. We had not loved you with our whole hearts. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. God is salvation, our rescue, our health. All things are yours. And when we bring hearts, hands, and voices to worship, we bring you what is yours. Yet we do not serve you as we ought. And the world is deeply torn by all the tension and the outright conflict. Come from worshiping less than yourself, our God, with others, has no firm foundation, humbles at the first side of real testing. In our personal affairs, in our larger judgments, we try to heal deep with superficial cures. Holy and loving God, forgive us. Confront us with your way of righting wrong, your strange and wondrous work of redemption through the sacrifice of Jesus. I'm going to ask the communion servers to come up. And you will notice that we have two stations. We also have a gluten-free option if you choose or if you need to. The gospel tells us that on the first day of the week, our Lord rose from the dead, and he appeared to some of his disciples and was made known to them of the breaking of the bread. It is true for us as well. Christ is made known to us as we break the bread and drink this cup together. As we prepare to come to the Lord's table, we reflect on our reasons for thanksgiving and faith, and our need for forgiveness and love. In this time of silence, we remember our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who called us to share this meal together as we thoughtfully examine where we are in our faith. Let us reflect as a body of Christ. You can also be seated if you need. Sisters and brothers, this is food for the journey to which God has called us. Let our lives be nourished by the Lord himself as we celebrate together at this table. You can come up whenever you are ready. The Apostle Paul tells us that on the night in which Jesus was betrayed, he took bread when he had given thanks, and he broke it and said, "This is my body for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Paul also tells us that the same way after supper, he took the cup saying, "This cup is the new covenant. In my blood, do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me." Paul then reminds us that whenever we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the death of Jesus until he comes again. Amen.
this life and breathe on this heart that is now yours. You can have it all, Lord, every part of my world. Take this life and breathe on this heart that is now yours. You can have it all.
You can have it all, Lord. Every part of my world. Heart that is now yours.
You can have it all.
You can have it all, Lord.
Every part of my
world.
Please take this life.
Take this life and breathe on this heart that is.
Thank you. who surrendered everything,
who surrendered everything,
all the peace
and all the peace that comes
when I'm broken,
when I'm broken.
Every part of my world.
this heart that is now
every part of my world, take this life and breathe on. This heart that is now yours.
Church, will you, if you're able, will you come to your feet and receive this benediction? If you feel comfortable, would you extend yourself and you can join hands? But if you are worried about germs, you're feeling sick, you can just do nux. What else can they call? Not nux, pound it. What's the verb for that? Do that. Well, everyone's holding hands. Okay. Church, receive this word as you go out into a new week. Huh? In 2 Corinthians, Paul just says, whoever is in Christ, that's the community part, whoever is in Christ. In the Greek, it doesn't have any extra words. It just says, boom, new creation. Whoever's in Christ, new creation. Whoever's in Christ, behold, it's just new. It's the old things are gone, the new things have come. So that's you, community. So now go into this week practicing communion with all things and all people, that might change everything. So go, community of the living God, alive and at work in you, to love and to serve this world. In the name of Jesus, go in peace. Amen.